Hello everybody, my name is Petr Koutný and today I am going to show a really amazing chess game of great magic man from Riga, Mikhail Tal as White, former world chess champion and one of the most famous chess player ever, against Florencio Campomanes. And Florencio used to be president of FIDE, man who decided to not continue it. World Chess Championship match Karpov against Kasparov. So, big man of chess history, and let's see this game because you will see another chess beauty. You will see another amazing performance of Mikhail Tal and another magic on the board. So, hopefully you are going to enjoy this game, and if yes, feel free and press like or press follow and be our new follower because another Tal's games are coming soon. So thank you and let's come back because we are watching Karokan defense and exactly Tal on move and he's playing move e6. Yes, this move is not winning. This move is not losing. Even white will be pawn down, but that's exactly move what we are accepting from Mikhail Tal. Go and attack, and of course he's going and he's attacking e6 and bishop d3. Threat is a check on g5 and g6 check and mate. Okay, if black is not careful and playing stupid move a6, so check g6 and maybe this is a style of Mikhail Tal. That's exactly first threat, but yes, black is not a weak chess player and he played immediately knight f6, so for the first time black stopped this threat, but maybe a loss of time, and time is important not only in chess, but of course it's important even in our lives, so never ever waste your time, because time is very expensive. So knight f3, g6, h4, and Tal is going for attack. h4, h5 is a threat, and c5. Yes, I think that black is doing everything well. He's looking for counter-attack in the center, and that's the best way how to play against maybe Mikhail Tal, or how to play against every attacker. Just believe that the best defense is attack in the center, and that's nice move. So Tal took it on c5 and now he played queen e2. Why he is going queen e2? Because he is not looking exactly to this black's double pawns, but he is looking exactly to black's king on e8, and that's a target. That's the plan. That's a simple but the best plan, and Mikhail Tal was maybe the best attacker of all time. So bishop g7 happened, bishop d2, and let's hurry to long castle. Long castle happened and e5. Mikhail Tal played bishop g5, and still I believe that black is doing everything fine. His center is strong, and maybe white has not time to go and to attack, because a center is important, and you know, if one player is losing a center, is losing a game, of course. So maybe this position is double edge, but don't worry, Mikhail Tal has a plan. Bishop e6, and now first attacking move, knight b5, and black is losing another time, and that's the biggest problem for black. He is losing time. He is not ready to go maybe for a short or long castle, and that's important for Tal to keep this piece in the middle of the board as long as possible. So h5, and that's a second pawn down, but still, who cares about pawns if Mikhail Tal is attacking? So knight d4. Wow, yes, exactly, that move is working, and it's working because here is a pin to black's bishop on e6. Yes, I can't understand how it's possible to play chess like Mikhail Tal. How is possible to have such a big amount of fantasy, energy and chess beauty. So bishop g4, f3 happened and e4. Still, black is looking for counter-attack in the center, but one big accident happened to black. What about his army? What about his pieces? You know, black's king is nearly alone and that's a bad, of course, that's a bad for black, and that's good for us because we are enjoying another amazing victory of Mikhail Tal. Okay, so piece, another piece, and the difference between a black's army and white's army is such a huge that now we are only waiting for final attack. So you will not wait forever because knight f5 happened and good black played nice move. He is going to attack on b2. He placed his queen to the center, so maybe everything is fine. But still, what's the biggest black's issue? The biggest black's problem is a piece on e8. And maybe even bigger black's problem is that white is Mikhail Tal. So he took on g7 without any doubts, and now he took on d5. And now what about king on e8? And what about the knight on e4? One of these pieces will lose, or will not survive this position. So black decided to take on g5, but now is waiting the final blow. Check on b5, check on f1, and I think that you don't need to be Mikhail Tal to believe that white is winning. What do you think about this game? You know, looks like simple game, but you know, chess is hard game, and chess is beautiful game. I think that chess is the best game ever, or chess is not a game, chess is the lifestyle, and I'm really enjoying watching this game. So check on b5, check on f1, and now check on d3. Yeah, too many checks, and you know, now the last question, are you able to find a winning white move? Just only one move, 5 seconds to you, and enjoy this position, and let's play this position like Mikhail Tal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and hopefully you found it rook h1, and that's a checkmate, or huge losses for black, so black resigned it, but that's a position, that's a move, and that was another brilliant game of Mikhail Tal. Hopefully you enjoyed. And if yes, feel free and press like or press follow and make my day, because I'm going to make another Tal's video soon. So don't miss this video, be our follower and stay by me. Thank you, enjoy, see you soon, take care, bye bye.